Hello everyone, I'm Sejun Kim, graduate student of Electronic Computer Engineering in Sakung University, Seoul, Korea. Co-authors are graduate student Sun Young Kwon and Professor Ki Sung Seo. The topic I'd like to talk today is Enhancing Diverse Inter-Identity Representation for Visually Impaired Person Re-Identification. Person re-identification is a repeatable task of matching the same person across multiple camera views as shown in the figure below. The goal is to rank the target as the most similar to the query. In the ranking display, numbers 1 to 7 are shown, where green indicates a correct match and the red indicates a mismatch. The ranking method involves inputting all images into the encoder, compressing them into a low-dimensional vector, and calculating a similarity score. Person re-ID is applicable to search for missing person or track criminals. For effective results, deep learning model needs to generate discriminant representations as depicted on the right side of the figure. This can be visualized as a circle in a multiple-dimensional embedding space. The representations ensure that individuals of the same identity as a query are close, while those of different identities are positioned far away. Next, I will explain visually impaired person re-identification, which is more challenging than normal person re-identification. As shown in the figure, visual images captured during the daytime and the impaired images captured during the night exhibit significant differences. The key issue here is the large modality gap. Now, I'm introducing the proposed method. First, we present novelty problem of inter-instance variance. Data augmentation for model robustness cause of filtering dominant features. This is because the intra-modality intra-identity representation space called IIRS becomes smaller. This limits the representation of various features, also limits the performance improvement. IIRS is the Euclidean distance averaging between features of same identity of the same modality. The figure shows the intra-instance variance problem by separating the train and test. In the train, random variation called RE has a strong effect by erasing parts of person's body, but this will make a modality gain more vigor. Because model training focuses on dominant features, each sample in the test are easy to respond to, but hard samples are difficult to respond to. Right side of the figure, existing method are limited representation in training, so in the test shows separate modality. On the other hand, the proposed method learns the ability to representation various features in the training process and shows the integrated modality space in the test. To demonstrate our argument, we compare IIRS numerically with loss functions and sample diversity. A bold box on the table denotes a large value between two losses. As a result, WRT loss shows a smaller IIRS and performance compared to HT loss. This means that WRT is more difficult to respond to for various input samples than HT. Therefore, machine learning capable of diverse feature representation for intra-identity is necessary. We propose an inter-identity representation diversification method called IRD to effectively solve the inter-instance variance problem. This method effectively reduced modality gain while extending IRS. IRD consists of two components, one positive enhancement and the other negative enhancement. IRDP is for various feature representation to similar feature representation suppress the dominant feature by keeping a small distance. In equation 3, the first term, two central features of different modalities are made close, and the second term, sample features of the same modality closest to the central feature are made distant. And the control in margin 0.1 intervals as shown in the figure at the bottom right. IRDNE is separate from other identities, allowing the IRS to expand further. As a result, the combination of PE and NE makes IRS effective in improving performance by extending to run discrete representation abilities and to become more separate from other identities. In addition, we propose a data augmentation method called Hue-Gray transform. This method increases the diversity of input samples of increase the inter-instance variance. First, it transforms random 1 to 360 degrees to Hue transform. An example of this shown first row. It generates samples of various colors. Second, using grace transform generate a very sample similar to infrared. Therefore, it is possible to create an intermediate modality image that is diverse and similar to infrared. Therefore, the total IRD losses is as follows. IRD methods between visible and infrared, and between hue gray and infrared. Here, loss hue gray and infrared, that is color invariant loss, which is useful in color invariant learning. Finally, the sum of all losses show equation 8. We set the coefficient as stable by considering the ratio of backpropagation 1 to 1. In other words, figure of right side, stable learning is possible by keeping the backpropagation ratio of the classifier and the loss of ratio of the remaining retrieval learning the same. The overall model framework is as follows. The proposed method hue gray and IRD are applied, and the model dispersive layer uses one layer based on the existing base model, and the remaining stages of ResNet 50 are used as shared layers. We explain with the two benchmark data sets. Each data configuration is as follows. The first data set name is SYSU-MM01 data set. The second data set is a RegDB data set. As compared to the state of the art performance, the proposed method achieves the best performance. In SYSU-MM dataset in indoor search mode, compared to the existing SOTA, ranking 1 improved by 3%, MAP by 1.94%. In negative dataset, infrared to visible mode, compared to existing SOTA, ranking 1 improved by 1.33%, MAP by 2.94%. Comparison of IRS with the component of the proposed method. Looking at when any NDP applied expectedly in the proposed IRD method, index 2 applying only any without considering the expansion of IRS has reduced IRS compared to index 1, which is the best model, and the performance improvement is not significant. However, applying only PE considering the extension of IRS as in index 3 increases IRS and increases the performance. And when any NDP are combined, they show higher IRS and performance. In addition, as shown in index 5, it shows superior performance even by increasing sample diversity, example HG. Therefore, we demonstrate the validity of the proposed method considering the extension of IRS. In addition, in comparison with IIRS with the existing method, the proposed method show high IIRS and the performance. Next, the top 10 retrieval result. Consequently, existing method retrieval almost similar images. On the other hand, the proposed method retrieval diverse and correct images. In the example, the existing method focused the back of the person wearing a bag, but the proposed method retrieval various images such as the front of the or the side. Therefore, the proposed method can represent various features away from the dominant features. In the hard sample, existing methods retrieve incorrect images, and in the case of CAJ, they are dominant in red images features. On the other hand, the proposed method copy well to hard samples. This is the result of the comparing activation map using CloudCam. Existing methods focus on limited body parts. On the other hand, proposed method focus on various body parts. Therefore, the proposed method demonstrates that the ability to representation various features is superior. The last conclusion. We present novelty problem of intra-instance variance, also demonstrated using IIRS. To solve this problem, we propose intra-instance representative diversification learning and hue gray transform. The proposed method demonstrates theoretically validated quantitative and qualitative evaluations. Finally, in order to effectively reduce the modality gap, a learning method that capable of the extension of IRS is necessary. Thank you for listening.